Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Paul's Halls. My name is Paul, and this is my hall. This is the Selbyville Public Library's book haul and what books we ordered and received in the last week. It is July the 11th. It is a Monday, and I hope there are some amazing books in this haul today. Make sure that if you missed this video, you can subscribe on YouTube to watch it. Or you could go to our website at selbyvillelibrary.org. Under the books menu, there is a Paul's Hall link. Also, make sure you check it out on Facebook. And please leave a comment, subscribe, and like, and share the video. So let's get to the books. Let's see what we got today. Our first box today includes some large print books. The first one is from Jenny Weiner. It is The Summer Place. This next one I'm excited for because I read the first book and I loved it. It is from Rebecca Roanhorse. It is called Fevered Star. This is a series that is a fantasy mythological spin-off of Aztec and Mayan culture, and the first book was phenomenal, and I can't wait to read this one because the first one ended on a cliffhanger. The next book we have here is a new Stephen Hunter book. It is called Targeted. This is a Bob Lee Swagger novel. This one is from Karen Hamilton. It is called The Ex-Husband. Let's read the back of this one. It's an offer she can't refuse and might not survive. Charlotte has an unsavory past, but she's on the straight and narrow these days. She was so young then, she married the wrong man, falling for Sam's sweet talking charm and charisma, and got caught up in his con artist games. If only she'd left him before things went too far. Now Sam is missing, but before he disappeared, he left urgent, cryptic messages about someone threatening him. Someone who has been threatening Charlotte too. So Charlotte takes a job as a personal assistant for an engagement party aboard a private luxury cruise ship, the Cleobella, to get away from anyone who means her harm. But as the Cleobella sails through its glittering destinations, increasingly sinister events haunt the guest, and the turquoise waves and sun-drenched beaches give way to something darker. Someone knows what Charlotte did. Dun, dun, dun. Is it the blushing bride, the seemingly placid mother-in-law, or the mysterious heiress? Someone knows and someone wants revenge before the ship reaches its final port. That sounds like a lot of fun. I love these type of Agatha Christie, stuck on a boat, stuck on a trade, stuck in a house type mysteries where one of the people in the area is a murderer. All right, we have a couple books from the Junior Library Guild. For kids, this is called Treasure Tracks. It's from S.A. Rodriguez. It seems like a book about a young boy that is a diver and wants to find treasure. Ooh, we have a new Aaron Entrada Kelly kids book. It's called Those Kids from Fawn Creek. All right, next box. A lot of stuffing. Okay, in this box we have Escape from James Patterson and David Ellis, a Billy Harney thriller. We have Tom Clancy, a Jack Ryan Jr. novel called Zero Hour. This is by Don Bentley. We have the newest Eve Duncan novel. This is from Iris Johansson. It is called A Face to Die For. We have a Janet Oak book here. It is called Unfailing Love, When Hope Calls, book number 3. We have a new Janet Daly book. It is called Hope Creek. If you like romance, give Janet Daly a try. Next, we have the continuation of Clive Cussler's books. It is now being written by Graham Brown. It's called Dark Vector. This is a book from the Numa Files. Then we have Tom Clancy's Op Center, Call of Duty. All right, last box, and it's the biggest box. Let's go. All right, the first one we have is a manga. This is the prequel to Jujutsu Kaisen, a manga that I just started the last week that is really, really good. And I'm looking forward to reading this. We have Tiffany Haddish. She has Layla, the Last Black Unicorn. This is from Derek Wilder. It is called, Does a Bulldozer Have a Butt? It does it? I don't know. This one is from Chris Van Dusen. It's called Big Truck, Little Island. Next, we have the newest Melanie Watts Scaredy Squirrel. It's a Scaredy Squirrel in a nutshell. We have these Ordinary People Change the World biographies, and this one is about Dolly Parton. Brad Meltzer writes some of these. Next, we have a new book from Emma Todd. It's called I Believe in Me. I believe in me too, Emma Dodd. Next, we have a Blue Truck book. It's Time for School, Little Blue Truck. These are written by Alice Schertle, and these are extremely popular. Next, we have Home is Where the Birds Sing by Cynthia Ryland. Very beautiful book. This next one is from Min Lee. It is called The Blur. Every little kid thinks they can run like super fast. I remember when I was a kid, I used to think I could run like super fast, but I really, really couldn't. This one is from John Arno Lawson. It's called A Day for Sandcastles. Perfect beachy book for kids. Next we have Hot Dog. It's by Doug Slatty, maybe? And this is a fun little book about a dog that runs around near the beach as well. To continue the beach theme, we have Little Houses by Kevin Henkes. I just love this cover and this book. This is from the Fan Brothers. The Fan Brothers write my favorite kids' books. It is called Lizzie in the Cloud. I just love their books because of the art and the messages in it, but look at some of this art. This is just a beautiful book. Next we have Smaller Sister, a graphic novel from Maggie Edkins Willis. Another graphic novel, it is The First Cat in Space Ate Pizza by Mac Barnett and Sean Harris. We have a couple Pokemon mangas for juveniles. This is Adventures XY. And then volume 2 of Black to White 2. All right, one more juvenile book. We have Growing Pains from Catherine Ormsby. And next we have Cinder in Glass from Melissa De La Cruz. Okay, I think the rest are adult books, but I'll probably be wrong. Colleen Hoover, this is called Ugly Love. Vacation Land from Meg Mitchell Moore. This is the Selma Blair autobiography. It's called Mean Baby, a memoir of growing up. We have Yerba Buena by Nina LaCure. Running out of room on the table. This is a YA book from Wendy McIver. It is called Relic in Ruin with a skull on the front. There's another young adult book. It is Kings of Bemore from R. Eric Thomas. We have Jill Chalvis, The Friendship Pact. And the last book is Adventures in Fosterland. This is a kitten lady from Hannah Shaw, and it's called Super Spinach. All right, so those are the books this week. What looks good to you? What are you looking forward to reading? And what are you reading right now? Let us know. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And we appreciate your patronage. See you next week.